I run Rice Is Nice Records, which is an Australian independent record company, which has been going for the past 5 years.
5 years in which the small label, like countless others, has created big waves using YouTube to break new artists. But the bubble of internet freedom that gave indies an audience is now set to burst. Should YouTube go ahead with its threat to block labels and artists who have not signed up for its new subscription service, rumoured to be called YouTube Music Pass?
It felt like there was an even playing ground in that social media space. So yeah, to have that now controlled by the majors yet again is incredibly infuriating.
YouTube's decision to block independent artists from their platform speaks to how important music streaming has become to an industry which has been playing catch-up on delivery for decades.
In Australia alone, we had the lowest recorded music revenue on record in 2013, and the one highlight from that was streaming revenue doubled. It's easy to forget that YouTube is the biggest music streaming service. No one is as big as YouTube at the moment from a pure discovery element. It's the first point of call for basically a generation.
And it could be closed to all but a few big players, just like the record industry was before. YouTube has signed lucrative licensing deals with music industry heavyweights Sony, Warner and Universal. But one estimate has indies collectively accounting for 32.6% market share of the recorded music industry sales and streams. The platform, owned by Google, has about 1 billion monthly views. Their incoming premium music subscription service will have to compete with other services like Spotify, Apple's Beats Music, even their own Google Play. It's just another example of the big guys trying to lock down intellectual property in a competitive digital market. For example, Amazon is being choosy about what book titles they sell, which are in direct competition with the titles that they own the copyright for. Representatives of the independent music labels overseas said YouTube has made a catastrophic error of judgment in misreading the market.
Many independent labels were offered take-it-or-leave-it deals that those independent labels didn't want to accept because the terms that were being offered are inferior to the terms being offered by comparable streaming services. If they launch without us, we think it's going to be an inferior service and it's not going to do well.
The feed contacted Google for comment.
We're adding subscription-based features for music on YouTube with this in mind. To bring our music partners new revenue streams in addition to the hundreds of millions of dollars YouTube already generates for them each year. We're excited that hundreds of major and independent labels are already partnering with us.
But like with anything online, it's how we use it that determines its success or failure.
It's quite frightening to hear that they do have that absolute control over us if we don't agree.